गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इम्प्रॉपर इंटीग्रल्स। सो द फॉलोइंग टाइप्स ऑफ इंटीग्रल्स आर नोन एज इम्प्रॉपर इंटीग्रल्स। सो दिस थ्री टाइप ऑफ इंटीग्रल्स आर नोन एज इम्प्रॉपर इंटीग्रल्स। हियर ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट, वेयर ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट, हियर ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट एंड एफ ऑफ एक्स इज कंटिन्यूअस इन द इंटरवल। एफ ऑफ एक्स इज कंटिन्यूअस in the interval. Okay, these three type of integrals are known as improper integrals. See, observe here integrals. In lower limit, upper limit, sometimes you may occur infinite. So, if you have one limit is infinite, so we can say these integrals as improper integrals. Now, let us learn how to solve this improper integrals. Okay. So these improper integrals are defined as the limits of remain integrals as follows. See how they are defined. Suppose it is integration a to infinite f of x dx, then it is defined as limit t tends to infinity a to in place of infinity, you can write t f of x dx. Okay, suppose this is minus infinity to a f of x dx, minus infinity to a f of x dx, then we can write limit t tends to minus infinity t to a f of x dx. So we are writing the improper integrals in limits of remain integrals. Suppose the third integration, improper integration, minus infinity to infinity f of x dx, then we can write this as limit t tends to infinity minus t to plus t f of t dt, f of x dx. So we can solve this improper integrals by using limits of remain integrals. Okay. So let us solve few example problems on improper integrals. First problem, example 1, evaluate integration b to infinity 1 by a square plus x square dx. So b to a infinity 1 by a square plus x square is the given improper integral. So here I am writing limit t tends to infinity in place of t, and in place of infinity I am writing t, b to t f of x dx is 1 by a square plus x square dx. So we know the integration of 1 by a square plus x square, that is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So limits are b to t. And limit in here, limit t tends to infinity. So I am substituting upper limit and lower limit in this integral. So what we will get? Limit t tends to infinity, limit t tends to infinity 1 by a, I am taking 1 by a outside, which is constant, 1 by a tan inverse, in place of x I am substituting t by a minus tan inverse b by a, upper limit minus lower limit. So I am substituting t tends to infinity here, 1 by a tan inverse infinity by a is infinity minus tan inverse b by a. So when we will get in tan infinity, tan pi by 2, so 1 by a here you will get pi by 2 minus tan inverse b by a. Okay. Okay, right. One more example on the same example, but limits are 0 to infinity, 1 by a square plus x square dx. So what we got, b to infinity, we got b to infinity. In the same manner we can solve this problem also. Suppose I am using limit of remaining integral. So how we can write? We can write limit t tends to infinity here, integration 0 to t 1 by a square plus x square dx. So what is the integration formula here? Limit t tends to infinity 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So by taking 1 by a outside, limit t tends to infinity tan inverse t by a. So why? Because limits are 0 to minus tan inverse 0. So I am substituting t tends to infinity here. By substituting t tends to infinity here, you will get infinity, tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse 0. Tan inverse infinity is pi by 2 minus 0. So this is pi by 2a. Okay. Suppose the limits for the same integral, another example 3, if it is if it is minus infinity to plus infinity 1 by a square plus x square dx, then by using limits of Riemann integral, how we can write? Limit t tends to infinity minus t to plus t 1 by a square plus x square dx. And we know that if the definite integral having minus limit to plus limit, then we can check this function is even or odd. So here f of x is 1 by a square plus x square, and we can observe that if you put minus x again, you will get f of x, so which is even function. Therefore we can conclude f of x is even. If it is even, how we can integrate this limit? How we can write this integration? Limit t tends to infinity 2, lower limit becomes 0, into t 1 by a square plus x square. So when the function is even function, if it is odd function, integral becomes 0. So 2 I am taking outside, integration value 1 by a tan inverse, and 2 into here limit also. Limit, you should write limit. T tends to infinity. Okay. 1 by a square tan inverse x by a 0 to t. 2 by a constant, take outside, limit t tends to infinity tan inverse t by a minus tan inverse 0. Now substitute limit t tends to infinity here. What we will get? 2 by a tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse 0. So this is 2 by a into pi by 2. So this is pi by a. So pi by a is the solution of this integral. Okay. Suppose same integral, if you have another example, minus infinity to a, f of x dx, 1 by f of x dx is a square plus x square dx. Then to solve this, again I am writing limit t tends to infinity, so minus t to a 1 by a square plus x square dx. Limit t tends to infinity, here we will get 1 by a tan inverse x by a minus t plus a. So by substituting in the, upper limit, lower limit in the function, we will get t tends to infinity 1 by a upper limit tan inverse a by a becomes 1, upper limit, lower limit tan inverse of minus t by a. right? So here tan inverse 1 is pi by 4 limit. We substitute limit t tends to infinity 1 by a. Here tan inverse of tan pi by 4 value is 1 minus here tan inverse of minus infinity. So minus infinity we can write as tan of minus pi by 2. Tan of minus pi by 2 minus infinity. So you will get 1 by a pi by 4 minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. So what is the LCM? 1 by a 4 is the LCM 3 pi by 4. 3 pi by 4 into a is the value of the improper integral. One more example problem on improper integrals. Evaluate 0 to pi by 2. This is a definite integral, not improper integral. But when we are modifying the function, we will get the improper integral. Okay, 4 sin square x plus 5 cos square x dx. So solve this. I am dividing the numerator and denominator by cos square x. Solution, in the solution I am dividing the numerator and denominator by cos square x. So 1 by cos square x is secant square x by here 4 tan square x plus 5. Why? Because sin square by cos square is tan square. Cos square cancel. Dx. So here I am keeping tan x is equal to t. Put tan x equal to t, then secant square x dx will be dt. And limits also. If x is 0, then t is 0. If x is pi by 2, then t is infinity. Okay, now limits converted to infinite. So we are getting improper integral after substitution of this. So integration becomes 0 to t. Sorry, 0 to infinity 1 by 4 t square plus 5 dt in place of tan t. So t square secant square dx becomes dt. Limits become 0 to infinity. Now here I am taking 1 by 4 common from the denominator. 0 to infinity 1 by t square plus, you can write this as root 5 by 2 whole square dt. 5 by 4, no, 5 by 4 I am writing root 5 by 2 whole square. So this is 1 by x square plus a square. So 1 by x square a square formula, 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So 1 by a, 1 by root 5 by 2 tan inverse x by a, t by a. So by root 5 by 2 means 2t by root 5. Limits are 0 to infinity. Okay, right. Now I am substituting these limits. So by simplifying here, you will get 1 by 2 root 5 tan inverse infinity by substituting upper limit minus tan inverse 0 by substituting lower limit. 1 by 2 root 5 tan inverse infinity, so it is pi by 2 minus 0. So what we got here, pi by 4 root 5 is the value of the integral, improper integral. Okay, so in the similar way you can complete exercise 9.5. okay, complete the exercise 9.5. so you have two problems in exercise 9.5. so after 9.5 we have reduction formula. Let us discuss about reduction formula. Reduction formula. Right? So we have four types of reduction formula. Reduction formula 1. First write reduction formula 1. Reduction formula 1. Reduction formula 1. If integration IN is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sin power nx dx, sin power nx dx, then IN equal to n minus 1 by n I n minus 2 I n minus 2, where n greater than or equal to. So I n equal to n minus 1 by n I n minus 2 for 0, limit should be 0 to pi by 2 and sine power nx. Here n may be odd or even, but greater than or equal to. So you can use this formula and step by step it will be reduced, power will be reduced, and you will get at the few steps, after few steps you will get the result by using this formula only for sine. If you have sine powers and 0 to pi by 2, you can use this reduction formula 1. Now reduction formula 2. If I n equal to 0 to pi by 2 cos power nx dx, then I n is equal to n minus 1 by n I n minus 2, same as sine function. You can use this formula when you have cos or sine, you can use same formula. Okay. To reduce the power. Reduction formula means we are reducing the powers. Now reduction formula 3. If I n equal to integration 0 to I m gamma n equal to zero to pi by 2 sine power mx cos power nx dx, then I m comma n is equal to n minus 1 by m plus n into I m comma n minus 2, where n greater than or equal to 2. Next, reduction formula 4. If you have sine cos function, use this formula. Okay. Now reduction formula 4. Fourth reduction formula. If I m comma n 0 to 1 x power m 1 minus x power n dx, then I m comma n n by m plus n plus 1 I m comma n minus 1, where n greater than or equal to 1. This is reduction formula 4. Okay. So here see, reduction formula 1 and 2 we can write as, we have 4 reduction formulas, no? So reduction formula reduction formula 1 and 2 we can write as both are same formulas, no? 0 to pi by 2 sine power nx dx, and another one is 0 to pi by 2 cos power nx dx so what is the formula? N minus 1 by n I n actually I n minus 2. Okay, here where n greater than or equal to. So this is the formula for both, common formula for both in reduction. So we can write this formula as, if you expand it, you will get n minus 1 into n into n minus 3 by n minus 2. So how we are expanding? From the numerator we are subtracting n minus 1, no? Next term n minus 3, n minus 5. From the numerators to the numerator n, first term n minus 1 by n. Next term n minus 3, next term n minus 5. Like that you have to subtract, right? So odd number we are subtracting from numerator, even numbers subtracting from denominator, n minus 4. So till to get 1 by 2. If you get 1 by 2 at the ending, if you get 1 by 2, then write pi by 2. So when we will get these values, if n values are even, 2, 4, 6, so on. N sine power is even or cos power is even, then you can apply this formula. Okay, otherwise again you can subtract same odd powers, odd numbers in the numerator, in denominator even n minus 2, so on, like that up to last step. If you get 2 by 3, then you have to write 1 year, 2 by 3. If you get 1 by 2 in the ending step, you can write by subtracting from numerator and denominator. At the ending stage, if you get 1 by 2, directly you can write 5 by 2. If you get 2 by 3, then stop the process. When you will get 2 by 3, if n values are even numbers, sorry, odd numbers, 3, 5, 7, so on. If n values are odd numbers, you will get 2 by 3 after reducing. So let us do one problem, then you can understand. So example problem. 0 to pi by 2 sine power 4x dx. So I have 6x dx, I am taking 6x dx. Right, now I am applying that formula. Actually n is here, what is n? N equal to 6. So what we have to do? First n minus 1, next to n. Next to n minus 2. Next, sorry, n minus 3 numerator, n minus 2. So on. Like that, how up to get 1 by 2, why? Because n is even, no? So you will get 1 by 2. If you get 1 by 2, you have to write 5 by 2. So if it is even, definitely you will get 1 by 2. So when you are getting 1 by 2, then write 5 by 2. I am using this formula. 6 minus 1 by 6 6 minus 3 by 6 minus 2. 6 minus 3 means 3. Okay, next 6 minus 5 by 6 minus 4. So observe here, 6 minus 5 is 1, 6 minus 4, 1 by 2. So this is 1 by 2. When you are getting 1 by 2, write 5 by 2 here. So what is the solution here? 5 by 6 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 2 into 5 by 2. 3 2s are. So this is 5 pi by 32. 5 pi by 32 is the answer. So if sine power is even, sine power is even, right? I am taking one more example. Suppose this is 0 to pi by 2 cos power 5x dx example. So I am taking odd power. So which formula we have to use? N minus 1, same formula. N from numerator we have to subtract odd numbers, from denominator we have to subtract even numbers until to get 2 by 3. Why? Because n is odd. If you get 2 by 3, stop the process. Let me check. So 5 minus 1, here n is 5, no, which is odd. So if it is odd, second formula we have to use. N minus 2, 5 minus 1 by 5, which is 4 by 5. 5 minus 3 by 5 minus 2. So observe here, 5 minus 3 is 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. So 2 by 3, we are getting 2 by 3, so stop the process. 4 by 5 into 2 by 3. So 8 by 15, 8 by 15 is the answer. So in this way you have to solve the problems. Okay. And reduction formulas. Reduction formula 3 also we can write as reduction formula. Formula 3 also we can write as, we can write as what is the reduction formula 3? That is 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2 sin power mx, sin power mx cos power nx dx. So here first case, If n is even and m is even, if both are even, if sin power, cos power both are even numbers, then you can write this formula 0 to pi by 2 sin power mx cos power nx as dx as n minus 1 by m plus n. First term n minus 3 by m plus n minus 2, n minus 5 by m plus n minus 4. So observe here, we are subtracting odd numbers from the numerator and we are subtracting even numbers from the denominator, so on. At the last step, we will get one by m plus 2. If you get 1 in the numerator, then stop the process. Okay, and stop the process and continue as m minus 1 by m. After getting 1 in numerator, in denominator we should get m plus 2. So after that, again continue m minus 1 into m, m minus 3 by m minus 2, m minus 3 by m minus 2, so on until to get 1 by 2. If you get 1 by 2, write 5 by 2. Okay, if m, n are even, then subtract the odd numbers from the term n, then you will get 1. After getting 1 in denominator, observe m plus 2. Then again into, from m you have to subtract the odd numbers until to get 1 by 2. Then if you get 1 by 2, write 5 by 2 there. Okay. Next case 2. Second case. If n is odd, if n is odd and m is any positive integer, either even or odd, so 0 to pi by 2 sin power mx cos power nx dx is equal to, you can write n minus 1 by m plus n into n minus 3 by m plus n minus 2, m plus n minus 2, so on up to get 2 by m plus 3 into 1 by m plus n. So if you get 1 by m plus 1, stop the process. If n is odd and m is any integer, either even or odd, depending on n. If n is odd, you have to use this formula. Okay. So using this formulas, you can solve the remaining problems.